In this video, we'll see some more array functions which are very important, which you will find it when you search in your which you will find its use in your web development. So, implode and explode functions. Here, implode, what it will do from the given array, the values are converted into a string. That means the array values are converted into a string using the implode. Whereas it is a reverse with the explode. The explode, it breaks a string into an array. Okay, so now we'll see, let me explain it with an example. The implode has this syntax, separator and array, and explode also has a separator, then string and limit. Now we'll see how the implode and explode works, and then I'll explain. Let us say we have an array called ARR. And we have this following values. These are all separate values. These are all the array elements. What the implode will do? The implode will convert, or it will form a string from the array elements. That is a function of implode. Now here we have implode. Then we have used space, comma, dollar array. How to mention the name of the array. So after the execution of this, what it will do? This is a separator symbol. So what do you mean by separator symbol? You see that, see here, this is the output. Hello. This hello is printed. This implode create a string from this array element. Hello with the space, again this word with the space, welcome space to space PHP. The whole thing is considered as a string. Which means these are all separate array elements in this $ARR. They are converted into a string with separator as space. So the next one is implode plus. Now it uses plus as a separator. See here, the whole thing is a string. Initially it was array elements. Now it converts into a string. Then here we used comma. So comma as a separator. So now I hope you understand the meaning of this syntax, separator and array. So you pass an array, the array elements are converted into a string. The array is still there, but it will form another variable, where a string variable where you can store this as a string. Then we'll see the explode operator, explode function. Now for this we have declared an string. This is a string as it is given within quotes 1, 2, 3, 4. This is given as a string. Now we are going to convert this to an array. So from the string you can form an array. So how to do that? That's what here we have given the separator. So up to which element it has to take one element. So that is what separator. And here you have given the name of the string. So after executing this, this $ARR will be an array. So if you see that, you can see, using the print underscore R, we print the value. So now you can see the zero index, the first value is 2. Then the first index, the value of 2, and so on. So now from the string, we are able to generate an array, as well as from this array, we are able to generate a string. So that can be done by this implode and explode. I just run this program. I'll show you this. It's here. We'll run this. We'll see how it executes. See here. Hello, well, and here this is a plus separator is given, and here comma separator. So all these things are a string. Whereas 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, everything which is given within quotes, which is nothing but a string, is now by using explode converted into an array